Hey, what's up, everyone? It's Derek from Nerd or Die, and I'm proud to introduce you to Fortified. This eventless design is the first of four parts that we'll be releasing for this pack, and in this video, I'll show you how to set everything up and also walk you through all of the options that it includes. This design is created with Fortnite streamers in mind, but can be adapted to work for almost any other stream, which can be done by taking advantage of the custom fields that we built into this widget. Let's get right into it. The Fortified event list will display your latest followers, tippers, subscribers, and much more. It's designed for use with Streamlabs and can support Twitch, YouTube Gaming, Mixer, Facebook, and even Periscope. While there are tons of options included, it's also created in a way that will allow you to start using it in seconds. The set features custom designed badges for different types of events, and a system that lets you change the colors of the badge background, badges themselves, and even the texture that's seen behind the text. You can change the color of the text and reposition it as needed. You can even hide certain parts of the event list if you prefer to. On the left, you'll see the default design, and then on the right, you'll see a design that I made with some changes to the custom options. Anyways, let's get a look how to install this pack, then we'll take a better look at each option. First, you'll want to download and extract the files from nerdordie.com for this video, and I'll just put this event list here on my desktop. We'll see a few files in the main folder. The first I want to point out is the Fortified Setup Guide. You'll want to click this link and you'll get right to our setup guide page, which details the process we'll cover in this video and also includes helpful images about the widget. Next, you'll find the Fortified Event List Setup for the Streamlabs file. To start, double-click the Fortified Event List Setup for Streamlabs link in your downloaded files. If you need to log into Streamlabs, go ahead and do so. If you'd like to keep this event list separate from other widget profiles that you made, choose Create Widget Theme and name it something appropriate, such as Fortified. The import link will only override your event list. This means you can combine this event list with any other widget themes you've made in Streamlabs. If you don't want to override your current event list, then we want to create a new widget theme. Next, select Use for the profile that you want to import this event list into. After a little bit, you should be brought to your new profile with the event list imported. You may notice the preview area does not properly animate the event list, so don't worry about that if it doesn't. This is completely normal. This area will only be used to look at the design and not the actual animations. So to look at the animations, let's add this into OBS Studio. We'll work on customizing it a bit later. Navigate to the widget URL and copy your unique URL. We'll go ahead and paste this into a browser source in our streaming software, and we recommend setting the size to at least 600 wide and 1,000 tall. This size may change depending on your customization options. And one thing I want to note is that we made this event list a lot bigger than what we expect to see it on in most streams. This is so that if you do want to use it for a larger situation, the resolution will be crisp and clear. You may want to use it at its natural size, but we do expect most people to scale it down, especially if your scenes include gameplay. If you need to scale down, you can do so directly inside of OBS Studio or your streaming software. Also, if you're using Streamlabs OBS, you may not need to complete this step if your event list is already added in. However, you'll probably need to edit the width and height to fit this appropriately. If you'd like, you can hit the test buttons a few times to get an idea about the overall size of the widget. Once you've sized everything appropriately, we can move on to the other options. As I said before, there are a lot of options, but before we change any, I want to mention that sometimes we'll need to refresh the page or the event list widget inside of our streaming software before all settings can take effect. So if things aren't working properly, just refresh the page or refresh the cache of your browser source in order to get everything to display as intended. Inside of OBS Studio, you can easily do this by clicking the Refresh Cache of Current Page button in your browser source properties. Also, we're planning on including a recommended style options on our website, and this will give you some ideas how to get different looks and styles for this event list. Let's start with the default ones included in Streamlabs. Options like theme and theme color will have no effect on this widget. Enable events allows you to decide which events you want to display inside the widget. Min options lets you set how many viewers for hosts, bits, or raiders for raids will trigger an event. Max events lets you change how many events are displayed at once. And background color is only for preview purposes up at the top of the Streamlabs page. Next, we have text color, which simply lets you pick the color for the usernames. And font allows you to pick the font family for usernames in this package. And the default here is Luckiest Guy. Animation and animation speed will have no effect on this widget. Fade time will hide the entire widget after X seconds, and we can set this to 0 to always display the widget. The other options allow you to flip the widget, so enabling flip Y will make the events come from bottom towards the top. Enabling flip X will make the events align to the right side. Please do not change the custom HTML and CSS options unless you know a bit about HTML, CSS, or JavaScript. We do not support custom changes. Anyways, I'll change a couple of the options around here a bit and hit Save Settings. You should see that the layout changes, but sometimes if we scroll up to the top and test the events, they might not work. And again, to fix this, just refresh the cache inside of OBS Studio and run the tests again. Now, I'll see my animations coming from the right side and the bottom area when I test the events. For the remainder of this video though, I'll disable flip X and flip Y and hit save settings one more time to get things back to the way they were. That covers the basic options, but let's take a deeper look at what else lies under the hood of this event list. Go ahead and click the custom fields tab to begin, and please do not click reset code or remove overlays. These custom field options are in place for those that like to tinker around and make the design more to their liking. So if you're happy with the default design, you can pretty much stop here. But if you want to go ahead and dig deeper, let's look at all these options. So first we have badge background color. There's a solid color behind each badge, and you can use this color picker to enter a specific color code here, or just simply choose the color that you like with the color picker. Badge base color will change the color of all of the badges. Personally, I'd like to keep these a bit more on the darker side, but honestly, it's up to you what you think looks best here. Badge scale lets you make the badges larger or smaller. Text alignment is pretty straightforward and allows you to decide which side your text will be aligned to. Typically, the best option here is centered, but if you decide to hide some of the elements, it might look better using right or left. Text padding is the space between the text and the edges of the board. Again, this option should be fine at its default, but if you want a more minimal design, you can decrease this option to get the text closer to the badges. Text shadow color lets you change the shadow color behind all of the text. A tip here is it's usually a good idea to have this be a contrasting color from your main text colors. So if your text is light, you'll want this to be dark and vice versa. However, sometimes it can look good even when you don't follow this rule of thumb. Fade out position is the number that you want your events to start fading out at. So let's say you have 5 total events shown. You can set this to 4 and then events number 4 and 5 will have a faded effect. Fade out opacity is the opacity of the faded out events. From our example above, events 4 and 5 will be at a 50% opacity if we leave it at this setting. Event spacing is the vertical margin between each event. And then show tag allows you to hide the tag in your events. These typically say follow, subscriber, etc. Tag font color is the color of the tag, if it's not hidden, of course. And then tag font family can be used to select a separate font for the tag section. Tag font size lets you choose bigger or smaller text for the event tags. Name offset and tag offset allows you to adjust the Y position of these text areas. This allows you to put your tags above the username or simply just adjust them. You'll find these options useful if you're changing the text size or font families. Show badge background, board texture, and board frame allows you to hide these respective elements. If you hide the board texture, a solid color will appear and take its place. Solid background color is the color of the shape that's in place of the board texture. And then solid background opacity lets you change the opacity of this shape. Let's say you don't want any shape or color behind your username and tag. Simply set this to 0 to hide it completely. And that's about it. So I'll wrap up a few of the tweaks to this design that I'm making and then go ahead and hit save changes. After that, we do need to refresh the source in order for our animations to work properly. Let's go ahead and test a few out, and then hopefully everything is working well. I do hope that it's obvious that you can see that we put a lot of effort into this in hopes that you can make it look and work the way you need it to. With that said, there might be bugs here or there, so if you spot any, please let us know via our contact form on our website. We try to get back to you as soon as possible. And then please let me know in the comments below what you think about this product or if you have any questions at all. If the video helped you out, don't forget to leave a like. Also, if you're interested in more great streaming and gaming related content, then don't forget to subscribe with notifications on. We do have some more additions to the Fortified design that are coming pretty soon, which I don't think that you want to miss. As always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.